Hello students, today after teaching you how to write notice, you have to learn how to write email in class 9 also, because that is the integral part of notice and email writing. In ICC, you have to write notice and email as an integrated part, okay, of each other. The questions comes like this. The notice comes on a topic, and on that topic, related with that topic, email also added in part A. Part A is notice, and if the part A is notice, and then the part B is email. Okay, so now I am going to teach you the format or how to write email in this class. In email writing, you have to know at first what is email. Email or electronic mail, the full form of email we can write like this, electronic mail, is a method of exchanging digital messages across internet to any person having a definite email address or ID. So you can send anyone who have the email ID or address all over the world. It is the quickest way to communicate in writing in all over the world. So we in our early days there were some mediums of writing letters to the person to take their will and abouts, but today we just we have applied the methods of email like this. So you have to know what are the kinds of emails. So there are three kinds of emails, okay? There are three kinds of emails. So what are they? The three kinds of emails are, first of all, formal, second, semi-formal, number three, informal. You do one thing, you just write down the things in your copy, okay? You write down all the things in your copy in a very good way, okay? And all these things should have to be written, because when you will go to learn these things, you will understand it clearly. Okay, so the three forms are formal, semi-formal and informal. So informal emails, whom we write informal emails? Formal emails we send to those person, those we don't know. So you don't know the people whom you write the formal email. Now semi-formal, you know the people or to the colleagues, to your colleagues. And informal, that is the emails that are sent to the friends, relatives or your close people. Okay, so now we are going to the format of an email. The format, the points, okay, I have written here the points of the format of email. So what are the formats? So first of all, to, that means to whom you are sending the email. So you have to write the email ID of that person here, and remember one thing, that the email ID should be written in us, all the letters will be in small letters, and there will be no space or gap between two words, okay? So all the letters should be written in small letters. Now the subject, no need to write the subject in small letters. The subject, what is the subject of the email? You are writing the email, and what is the subject of the email, you have to mention it here. Now the salutation, you know, you don't have to write like this salutation. You have to write like madam, sir, dear sir, dear madam. And whenever you are writing to your friends, you just have to mention the name with dear or respected like this. So now after the salutation, opening sentence, then body, then closing sentence, then subscription. Okay, so we have learned that there are three kinds of emails, that is formal, semi-formal and informal. And in the format, for the salutation, you have to know to and subjects will be the same way. we have to write the to and subject, these 2 points, in the same way in each of the formats, in each of the emails. Okay, now for the formal emails and in salutation points, you have to write like this: dear sir or madam, dear sir, madam, like dear Mr. Ghosh, like this. And do not use title and first name, like Dr. Mrs. Reena, like this. Don't use this kind of things. So you have to write like this: dear sir or dear madam or dear Mr. Ghosh or dear Mr. Sen, like this. Now in semi-formal salutation, you have to write like this: dear Arun, dear anyone's name, or if you are writing the form informal, you have to just mention dear brother, like this, dear Arun, dear Reena, like this. Okay, so this is the part of salutation. Now we are going to the part of subscription, that is the ending part. Body, we have to write body according to the subject, and to the subscription we have to write in the formal email, like yours faithfully, yours sincerely, thanks. And semi-formal you have to write like this: thanks, best regards, yours, like this. And informal: best wishes, all the best, like this. Okay, so now we have an example here written. I have written it for you. So the example is, I'm just reading the question. You write it carefully. Write an email to the principal of a neighboring school informing her of the event. Event is what? Because I have told the event already in the notice, and it is the related part of that notice. It is the related email of that notice, right? So I just mentioned the event in the bracket. So the event is inter-school drawing competition, and requesting her to send the students of our school. So this is the email. This is the question of the email. Now come to the part. So first of all, you have to write like this: to, and give colons. Now write the email ID of the principal or to whom you are writing the email. So here we are writing the email to the principal of a certain school. So look, I have written here the email ID in a full small letters. All the letters are in small. So principal Daffodil School, look, there is no space between the words. Principal is a word, Daffodil is another word, school is another word. So there is no space here. Remember it carefully: principal Daffodil School @gmail.com. Okay, so this is the address, this is the email address to whom you are sending the email, right? Now subject: inter-school drawing competition. You are writing the email to the principal about the inter-school drawing competition. Okay, now we have started the writing like with the salutation, like dear madam, because you are writing to her. Her means there is a lady, so you have to give regards to her, like dear madam, and put a comma here. And start your email after leaving one line, like a gap, and start from here. Like every year, our school is going to celebrate the Independence Day along with some inter-school competition. We'll stop. As part of the celebration, you have to make him know about the things which you are going to tell him, or you are going to inform her. As part of the celebration, we are hosting War of Colors. That was the catchy title of our notice. So that was the caption of the competition. So celebration, we are hosting War of Colors, an inter-school drawing competition. So that was the title or the caption of the competition, and that is why we have mentioned it here. War of Colors. Okay, full stop. This para ends here, where in the first para you are giving the details of the subject. Look, you are giving the details of the subject. Now, in the next para, it will be held on 15th August 2020. This is the time and place. In this para, we are giving the time and place information about the time and place. It will be held on 15th August 2020 from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. in the school's cultural hall. Okay, full stop. And in next para, you are requesting the person. Okay, you have written the email to request him to send her students to your school. So in this line, you are requesting her. Please do send your students to participate in the event. And now, this is the most polite thing. You have to write in a polite way. We look forward to your school's participation in the competition. Full stop. So the body is divided. I have divided it 1, 2, 3, and 4 part. Okay. In first part, that is a little bit long one. You have to give the description of the title. Now the place, time, place, and the request. Okay. Now give a one line space and write thanking you, yours faithfully. Then your name. Here I have left a blank space here. So in this first blank space, you have to write your name, and in last line, you have to write your designation. Okay. So that is the example or full format of an email. You have to write email in this way. And now I am going to give you some assignments to do in your home. As your home assignment, you take your book of English 1, Total English, number 9, and open page number 20. Open page number 20, okay? And here is the question number 3. Look here. Question number 3A. Your school is organizing an inter-school spelling bee contest. Spelling bee contest, you know, all the competition will be on spellings. Write a notice to be put in your school informing the students about the contest and inviting them to participate in it. Now in B, that is the integrated part, as I have told you, the email will be the integrated part of the question. So in question B, write an email to the principal of a neighboring school requesting him or her to send a team from his or her school to participate in the inter-school spelling bee contest. Okay, so this is the homework for you. You have to write it in your English 1 copy, and I will check the copy after the school opens. Thank you.